Welcome back to the homestead. Back out here this afternoon, and it's been a little while since I've been out here getting work done, but I thought I'd come out this evening and see if I could put up a few pieces of plywood sheathing on the house to try and give it a little extra wind shear protection. We've got some storms coming through and every little bit helps. So when we framed up the walls, we put some 2x4s across several of the studs and nailed them off for some bracing. But if I can get some sheathing on there, that'll stiffen it up quite a bit. The only problem is I'm out here by myself today, so handling a 4x8 sheet of plywood by yourself and getting it held up in place and nailing it off is a little bit of a chore. So let me show you how I'm going to do that. So for starters, since I'm building the house by myself, it's going to take me a little while to get it, the exterior of it, completely finished. So rather than sheathing the house with a OSB product, which I think typically they don't want exposed any more than 90 days if you're using like a zip system from Advantech or something, it's going to take me a good bit longer than that to get the siding up. So I'm going to use a half inch treated plywood for my sheathing on the house. So my sheathing is going to be just a little bit heavier than your average sheathing because I'm using half inch instead of 7/16. So in order to be able to install this on the side of the house and do it by myself, what I'm going to do is I'm going to install a temporary cleat on the rim joist of the house, and then I can just set my plywood on it. You can see here I've just attached a 2x4 temporarily to my rim joist. And I'm going to allow my siding to come all the way down to this point, and that'll allow me to tie my rim joist, my flooring, and my bottom plate, as well as the wall, all together as one continuous unit. And then, I don't know if it'll show up. Yeah, there we go. On this run, since I have a board coming out horizontal, I'm going to have to put some flashing over the top of this, and that flashing is going to come up to this mark here. So I'll have 3/4 of an inch or an inch of siding coming down over the top of the flange. So any water that comes down the wall will come down the sheathing, and then the flange will be tucked up behind that, so it'll get onto the sheathing and come on off. So we won't have any problems with water pooling. So all I've got to do is set that sheet of plywood up here on this cleat. And with that sitting in place, since that's level and the plywood is square, it should fall pretty much into place. And then I can use a clamp to just temporarily clamp the top of it, keep it from falling back while I'm adjusting it and getting it nailed off. So this first piece of plywood is going to have to be cut down just a little bit. It really needs to be 47 1/4 rather than 48 inches. So I'm going to go ahead and rip that piece of plywood up and come back and see if we can get that nailed off this evening. Alright, so that's the process I'm going to use to put the sheeting up. As you can see, one person, and I don't do this for a living, so it goes kind of slow. But you'll notice I'm putting them up with the nail gun, and then a lot of times I'm coming back with the regular hammer and driving the nail on in. And let me show you the reason for that. So when you set the nail gun up, you want to set it so that the head is just below the surface of the wood, but you don't want to overdrive it and crush the wood. But this treated plywood is not as straight and flat as what OSB would be. And because of that, it doesn't always pull in nice and tight like you see on this seam here. So sometimes, you have to come back with the regular hammer to go ahead and set the nail in a little bit farther and actually draw that plywood up to the stud like you see here. Now let me take you inside and show you what happens when you just use the nail gun. So here you can see there's a pretty good gap between the stud and the sheathing. And that's because when the nail gun drove the nail in, it did not pull the plywood all the way up to the stud. So what I'm going to have to do is go back with the hammer and make it pull in so that it looks like this stud. And it should look like that all the way down. So let me go in around the other side with the hammer and drive those on back in so that I've got a nice firm connection all the way down. Alright, so we've got all those pulled up real good and tight now. So those two sheets of plywood are done. And just two sheets, it's amazing how much more that stiffened up the structure over just having the 2x4s nailed to the studs on 45s. So we're going to work on trying to get a little bit more of this sheathing put up. And probably work on this until dark. All right, we're going to knock off for the evening. I'm starting to run into a problem of overrun. And I've got two sheets of plywood up here, which should be 8 feet. And I've got them butted up tight together. I really need a little bit of a gap in there. And you can see those two sheets, even though they're butted up tight together, are running right at 8 feet and a quarter. And what's going to start happening is, as I go down, this next sheet, instead of breaking in the middle of my stud here, it's actually breaking on the outside edge. So it's coming all the way to here, which means the next sheet won't have anything to butt up on. So I'm going to have to trim that next sheet down just a little bit so that I stay on the joist. And you can see up here at the very top on this sheet, we've already run into that problem. Where the edge of that plywood is already to the edge of the cripple. But since there's another sheet going on up there and that's nailing off on the header, that's not going to be a problem. But
as we go on down the wall, it's going to start being a problem, so I'm going to have to trim the next sheet to make them fall out right. And that'll be a project for another day. And when I come back, I also need to bring a half-inch hole saw so that I can start drilling the flashing for this wall, and I can go ahead and put sheathing up around this corner, so I'll have a few pieces of sheathing that direction and a few pieces that direction for wind shear both ways. But I can't put that sheathing up until I get the flashing up, because the flashing is going to come up the wall to here, and as you can see from this piece of sheathing around there, the sheathing is actually going to overlap the flashing just a little bit. So I've got to bring a hole saw to drill out for these anchor bolts. I'll take the nuts and washers off, put the flashing down, bolt them back down, and then I can attach the sheathing over the top of that. Like I said, that's going to be a project for another day. Just these couple of pieces of sheathing here actually strengthen it up quite a bit, but I would like to get some the other direction. Unfortunately, I don't know if I'm going to be able to beat the rain, because we've got storm front coming in Wednesday. Mike can work a little bit Thursday, and Friday, Saturday, and Sunday is going to be storms also. So maybe Thursday evening I can get a little bit of flashing or sheathing put on this wall, this direction, and sturdy it up the other way.